Good evening, WFA family, and welcome back to week three of our Season of Alignment series. Week one was crossing into the new, letting go of the old, allowing the Holy Spirit to give us a new wineskin in this season as the Spirit of God is pouring out something new. It's a Kairos season, and we don't want to miss the new that He's doing, so we're asking the Holy Spirit to really help us embrace and prepare us for the new. Week two, last week, we looked at the fire test, the fire of God that purifies us and cleanses us and reveals the condition of our heart. We looked at how we are to buy gold refined in the fire so that we can have what true richness is. And it's not the things of this world, but when we buy gold that is refined in the fire, which is refined by the Spirit of God, and we allow the Spirit of God to do that deeper work in us, we're passing the fire test. And that fire test involves living a life of repentance. And the fire test ultimately brings us into our identity and our inheritance in Christ. And that's what this week, week three, is about. I've titled it Walking into Our New Identity and Receiving Our Inheritance. Walking into our new identity and receiving our inheritance, week three. And these series are building on one another because I believe, first of all, we've got to recognize what season we're in to really align with what God is doing. And we recognize that it's new. We recognize that our old way, our old character, our old attitudes, our old heart conditions cannot stay in this new season. We've got to allow the Spirit of God to change us and transform us, and that comes through the refiner's fire process. And as we are refined and purified and cleansed, we grow into this new identity that is ours in Christ Jesus. And so this week, walking in our new identity and receiving our inheritance. We are children of God, and that is who we are. And as children, we have rights and we have privileges that have been purchased through the precious blood of Jesus. A high price was paid for us to have this inheritance. But we can't receive our inheritance in Christ if we don't know who we are in Christ, that identity. So as we buy that gold refined in the fire and we're purified and there's this working of holiness done in us, we begin to get a greater revelation and understanding of who we really are. And so in this season, as we're aligning and desiring to align with what God is doing, we need to pray for the baptism of the fire. The Word of God says that Jesus baptized with the Holy Spirit and fire. And we need a fresh baptism of the Holy Spirit, but we want to ask for that fire baptism because the fire of God is what's going to refine us and purify us and enable us to walk in this identity and then receive what the precious blood of Jesus has already bought for us. So the first point tonight I want to talk about is walking in our identity. I'm very passionate about this because God began to speak to me very profoundly at the end of last year in December, matter of fact. I wrote it in my notes, December the 27th, 2019. I was sitting in our room in our resort at Disney World, which was our Christmas present that was given to me by my natural earthly father. And it was such a blessing. We were sitting in a resort. We were sitting in a very nice hotel. And Will and Dee were in the park. And it was kind of a rainy day outside. And I just wanted to stay inside and enjoy the room and the blessing of this resort that in and of myself, I could not have afforded that. But my daddy blessed our family with that as our Christmas present. And so in the natural, I realized that that was a natural blessing, a natural right and privilege that I was getting as a daughter, and I was inheriting that from my earthly father. But God began to speak to me on a spiritual level. And He began to tell me, you know, that very few people really find who they were really created to be. Because either we settle for less, or either we compromise and allow sin to come in and live a life of compromise, which ultimately the enemy wants to destroy us with that. And that's sad, but it's true. And I begin to think, you know, Jesus has this amazing plan for all of us. The Word of God says that He knew us. He created us in our mother's womb. He had this beautiful plan, beautiful design. We're all His works, His design. He is our Creator. We are His creation. And He's got this awesome plan for us. And yet we go through life and very few people really find out who God created them to be. They live their own life. They allow the enemy and life's circumstances and situations and things to really cause them to settle or either compromise or ultimately destroy them. But I want to tell you, it's never too late to find our God-given purpose and plan and be able to allow God to fulfill that in our life. I don't care how young you are or how old you are, it is never too late to find out who you were created to be. And let me just tell you, God's ways are so much better and His plans are so much better than what we could even fathom on our own or even what our own plans and purposes are for our life. But the enemy comes to either distract us or either weary us, tire us out, or ultimately destroy us. But I'm here to tell you that we can overcome any life circumstances, anything the enemy is meant to destroy us, anything, any disappointment, any compromise, any settling, any intent that the enemy's had to destroy you from who God really created you to be. We can overcome that through the power of the Holy Spirit and through the blood of Jesus. And recognizing our identity and inheritance is a key part of us aligning to what the Spirit of God is doing in this season. And during that time, back in December, when God spoke that to me in that resort room that day, as I was spending time with the Lord and just really basking in inheritance, a natural inheritance, but even more so a spiritual inheritance, the next few nights I began to have dreams. And God has really had me in a season of dreams, prophetic dreams and spiritual dreams, where He's speaking to me personally about who He's created me to be and what my destiny is and what God's called myself and Dee and Will and our family into. But a lot of times God will take you back and revisit things, to deal with things, to heal things in you for Him to be able to move you forward into the fullness of the destiny that He has for you. And I recognize, without going into a lot of detail about these dreams, that that's what God was doing to me. He was giving me dreams to really bring some healing and to reveal my identity and to bring me into this inheritance that is mine in Christ Jesus, but also to be able to share it with the body of Christ. Because this doesn't just apply to me, it applies to every child of God, every person that's been purchased by the blood of Jesus and is in covenant relationship with God has an identity and has an inheritance in Christ, and it's being made aware of it and asking the Holy Spirit to bring it alive to you. So on December the 29th of 2019, I had a dream that had to do with my old identity, how I viewed my old self, my old nature versus my new. And God took me back in that dream to my grandmother's house. And in that place, my mother was there. And not to go into specifics, but I knew that this dream had to do with my identity and my inheritance, because it had to do with my mother and then my mother's mother and then me. And there again, you've got three generations there. And it had to do with childhood stuff. And what God spoke to me in that dream was so profound. And I knew God was speaking to me about identity and that I had to deal with some old stuff to come into the new that He had for me. And part of that revelation was that I realized that I've dealt with a lot of issues of rejection in my life, even as a little girl, and that I had tendencies that drew me to please people over pleasing God. I was a people pleaser. But that in this season of my life, even though I had struggled with that, that God was healing me of deeper roots of rejection, and He was healing me from any need to please people, but He was reversing that curse off my life, so to speak. He was breaking that rejection. He was breaking that old identity of people pleasing, and He was bringing me into a greater revelation that I was going to be a God pleaser more than anything. I was going to be a God pleaser, and that I wanted to please my Father, my Heavenly Father. I wanted His affirmation. I wanted His approval through my obedience to His will on my life more than I wanted to please people. And that I wanted to hear my Father say that He was well pleased with me because of my obedience to fulfill the call of God on my life. And that what He had created me to be and to do, that I had done it. And that when this life was over, that He could say to me, "Daughter, you finished well, and you did just what I had called you to do. You came into your identity. You recognized who I created you to be over any plan of the enemy, over any snare of the enemy, over any rejection, over any need to please people. You overcame that, and you walked in to your inheritance. And for that, I am blessing you and I'm rewarding you, because you came in to being to be able to do." And that's another point. We've got to be who God created us to be able to do what He's created us to do. And I want to live a legacy that influences God's kingdom. That when my life is over on this earth, I will hear my Heavenly Father say, "I did everything I was supposed to do in this life on this earth to advance His kingdom. And that I found who I was really created to be by Him." Then in January of 2020, God continued to speak identity inheritance. And I know that this is a year of identity inheritance, just as well as it's a year of freedom. It's a year of identity and inheritance. And a friend texted me and she said, "I just had this random thought." And she said, "And I think it has spiritual meaning." And God had already been giving me these dreams, giving me these words about identity inheritance for me on a personal level. And she said, "This is what the random thought is. If you fall down in mud, you don't become mud. You just become muddy." And immediately I said, "Absolutely. That has everything to do with our identity. Because when we go through stuff, that doesn't define us. When we go through muddy situations and messy situations, that does not define our identity. And what we do or have done in our past does not have to define us, does not have to be our identity, nor does what others do to us or have done to us or said about us or will say about us define us. What others do to us or say about us does not define who we really were created to be." And see, this gives us revelation about our identity, because our old identity is attached to doing. Our old identity is attached to what people say and people think about us. Our old identity is attached by our actions and our failures and our weaknesses and our performance and if we missed the mark or didn't miss the mark. But that's what grace is all about. That's what the blood of Jesus is all about. And as you can tell, I am passionate about this. I am fired up about this, because identity and inheritance is the key to us walking in freedom and aligning to what God is doing in this season. And I just believe, WFA family and friends, that God has got us in a place where He is speaking to us revelation that will transform us in a way we've never known before. On January the 7th of 2020, I had another dream about identity. And this time, it wasn't about my mother and my grandmother, my maternal grandmother. But this time, this dream had to do with my son and my daddy. So you see, God was dealing with my maternal side. And then later, He gave me a dream that had to do with my paternal side. And it had to do with inheritance. And in this dream, Will, my son, was helping me find a raincoat that my daddy, my natural earthly daddy, had purchased for me. And my daddy has bought me a raincoat. And on that raincoat, it is a very nice raincoat. It was one I wanted several years ago, and my daddy bought it for my birthday. And it was monogrammed with my initials on it. But in this dream, I can't find this really nice raincoat that has my initials, my personal initials on it. But Will helps me find find another raincoat. And he says, here, Mom, here's your raincoat. And I said, Will, that's not the one I'm looking for. That's a cheaper version. That didn't even have my initials on it. And the initials that are on it are not correct. But in this dream, I was adamant that I had to find the nicer, more expensive quality raincoat, the right raincoat that my father had bought me with my right initials. And when I woke up, I said, Lord, that dream has to do with inheritance, because you are telling me that the one that my father bought, even in the natural, was the nicer, more expensive one that had the correct right initials, that had my, that identified that that coat was mine and it was my rightful inheritance. And I'm telling you, in the spirit realm, God showed me that that's it. That's it. We've got to go after our right coat, our right identity, the one that has our name on it, not somebody else's, not a cheaper version, but our rightful inheritance. And don't let the enemy let you settle for a cheaper version or the wrong version or to compromise, but go after your rightful inheritance. Jason Moy shared at the beginning of this year that he had a vision in life classes one Sunday morning when we were praying and the Spirit of God was moving. And he said in that vision, he saw people walking into our church. And as they were walking in our church, he could see that they were headless in the spirit. And he thought, Lord, what is that all about? But after they would leave the church and they would go out, they would have their heads on. And he said he really felt like that there again, that had to do with inheritance and identity, and that we have orphan spirits. We're headless in the spirit realm. We don't even know who we are. We are those orphans searching and looking to know who we are. But when we leave out of the service, we've got our heads on because we have been healed. And this is the year for orphan spirits to be healed. And in the healing comes that rightful identity and inheritance that is ours in Christ Jesus. Romans 8, 16 and 17. And I just want to encourage you. You want to go after your identity? Read Romans 8. It is full of your identity and inheritance in Christ. And for time's sake, I'm not going to be able to go through all that. And I'm so excited about this, but I'm just going to touch on a few things. But Romans 8, 16 through 17 says, the Spirit himself testifies with our spirit that we are God's children. Now, if we are children, then we are heirs. If we are heirs with God, then we're co-heirs with Christ. If we share in his sufferings, in order that we may also share in his glory. The Spirit of God in us testifies that we are God's children. And if we're God's children, then we're heirs with God. We inherit what is ours as children, and we're co-heirs with Jesus. We inherit what Jesus inherits. And if that's suffering in this life, then it's also glory. 1 John 1 and 3 says, see what great love the Father has lavished on us, that we should be called the children of God. And that is what we are. The reason the world doesn't know us as those children is because they didn't even know Jesus. We're not to identify ourselves with the world. We're to identify ourselves with the identity that Christ has given us in him, that has been purchased by his blood. Galatians 4, 6 and 7 says, because you are his sons, God sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, and the Spirit calls out, Abba, Father. So you're no longer a slave, but you are God's child. And since you are his child, God has also made you an heir. Galatians 3, 26 and 29 says, so in Christ Jesus, you are all children of God through faith. For all of you who were baptized into Christ have clothed yourself in Christ or with Christ. There is neither Jew nor Gentile, nor slave nor free, nor is there male or female, for you are all one in Christ Jesus. So if you belong to Christ, then you are Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise. Abraham is the father of our faith. And we're heirs according to the promise that has been passed down through the blood of Jesus. Go into the Word of God. Find out the promises of God that are rightfully yours because you are a son or you are a daughter. And may you begin to identify yourself as that child crying out, Abba, Father, I want what you have for me. I want to know who I was created to be, and no longer do I want to identify myself with this world. No longer do I want to identify myself as a slave. No longer do I want to identify myself with my old nature, but I want to know my new nature, and I want to begin to walk in it so that I can receive my inheritance. And when we receive our inheritance, then when we receive our identity, then we can rightfully be able to receive the inheritance. That's key number two, receiving our inheritance. Ephesians 1, 13 and 14 says, And you also were included in Christ when you heard the message of truth, the gospel of salvation. Our salvation includes our identity. It includes our rightful inheritance in Christ. When you believed, you were marked in Him with a seal, the promised Holy Spirit. We are marked with a seal. The promised Holy Spirit marks us, church. Verse 14, who is a deposit guaranteeing our inheritance. What deposits in us? What guarantees our inheritance? The Holy Spirit of God. Until the redemption of those who are God's possession, we're God's possessions, to the praise of His glory. Last scripture, Ephesians 2, 4 and 10 says, But because of His great love for us, who is rich in mercy, He made us alive with Christ, even when we were dead in our transgressions, in our sin. It is by grace you have been saved. May the Holy Spirit of God give us greater revelation of grace in this season. Verse 6, And God raised us up with Christ. What's our inheritance? He raised us up with Christ. And what did He do? He seated us with Him in the heavenly realms in Christ Jesus. That's our position in Christ. That's our inheritance in Christ. Verse 7, In order that in the coming ages He might show the incomparable riches of His grace expressed in His kindness to us in Christ Jesus. For it is by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not from yourselves. It is a gift of God, not by works, so that no one can boast. Verse 10, Who are we? What is our inheritance? What is our identity? Verse 10, For we are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus, to do good works. We were created to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do. Church, we were created to be who God created us to be. And as we get a revelation of that, then we will be able to do what He has called us to do, which is good works that He has prepared in advance for us to do. God gives us grace to walk in this identity. He gives us a grace to receive this inheritance. And in closing, I want to say, the enemy cannot stand a person who knows who they are in Christ, because that person is a serious threat to the kingdom of God. Church, are you ready to be a serious threat to the kingdom of God? Because we've got an adversary, but greater is He that's in us than he that's in the world. We are more than conquerors. We are overcomers, and we can be who He's called us to be, and we can do what He's called us to do as we walk in this identity. Ask for a revelation of it, and then receive this inheritance and walk it out. I also want to close with this. And I wrote down out of Ephesians chapter 1, everything that Ephesians chapter 1 said that was my inheritance in Christ Jesus, I wrote it down in my journal. And I want to challenge you to do that. And then I want to challenge you, because it's the year of the mouth. It's the year of declaring and decreeing, to begin to declare and decree what your inheritance is in Christ. Faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. And it's going to stir you, church. It's going to cause your faith to rise. It's going to cause you to be able to walk in the identity and receive the inheritance, because you're going to believe it. And you're going to see, and you're going to believe in ways you never have before. And I wrote down in my journal 29 things that Ephesians chapter 1 tells me that is my inheritance. Maybe you'll get something different. But I wrote down 29 things, and I wrote them down, and I declare my inheritance. Make it personal. It's your inheritance. Wisdom and knowledge is our inheritance. Eyes of our heart to be enlightened is our inheritance. The incomparable great power is our inheritance. Mighty strength is our inheritance. All things under our feet is our inheritance. The fullness of Him who fulfills me in every way is our inheritance. Marked in Him with a seal, the promised Holy Spirit is our inheritance. Being adopted into sonship is our inheritance. The redemption through the blood is our inheritance. The forgiveness of sins is our inheritance. God's great love is our inheritance. The rich in His mercy is our inheritance. Alive with Christ is our inheritance. Oh, I could go on and on and on. And for time's sake, I can't. But go after it, church. One last thing. God give me a declaration and decree that was supernaturally ordained of Him during this season. And I want to close. And I want to declare. And I want to decree it over you. And I declare and I decree that we are children of God. We are heirs with God and co-heirs with Jesus. Our minds are set on things above, and our hearts desire the greater things of God. Our bodies are whole and healthy in Jesus' name. Our emotions are aligned to the Spirit of God. Our ways will glorify our Father in heaven, and our lives will produce the fruit of the Spirit. We will advance the kingdom of God, and we will see a fruitful harvest of righteousness. In Jesus' name, I bless you. Go after it, church. Walk in your identity. Receive your inheritance. God is doing great and mighty things. I love you and I bless you. In Jesus' name, amen. Mm-hmm.